What's up? So, because of the last reading, I felt we need to do a better check on the Queen of Swords. Now, I was thinking, maybe I'm feeling all of that because of the coffee. I haven't drank coffee in about a week or so, and now I'm drinking my first real coffee, and I'm just like, feel me? So, I'm kind of starting to get the jitters. I apologize to anybody if I am all over the place, but you guys know how it normally is when I have a lot of caffeine in my body and my system, so please forgive me. Nonetheless, we're about to get a more thorough check-in on the Queen of Swords. Towards the end, we'll probably get into the... What was his energy? Did he have an energy that came out for this opposing? I think it was the King of Cups. So the King of Cups energy, there was a secret with the High Priestess and the Emperor. Okay, so that was interesting as well. So, we got some explaining to do. So let's see what's going on. Praise the Most High for having us here. Let's get a part two, right? Let's get it right, part two, right? Okay, let's go. All right, so resting, charging up. As you can see, 3 out of 4 swords are up on the wall. We're good to go. We're almost there. You feel me? We just gotta get some more self-love, self-care. You already know. Eat some good meals. Maybe get a pedicure, manicure. Sit back, watch some good Netflix series. Have some snacks that don't have too much of a caloric intake. Because, you know, we do want to work on our physique. Summertime's coming up rather quickly. Anyway, I'm sorry. Let's continue. Let's see what's going on with this Queen of Swords. Oh. All right, so she's very good. All right, look at her. She's independent. She's confident, she's single, she's feeling and looking wonderful in her own lane, doing her own thing, in her own bag. I like to see that. Okay, now she's thinking about giving to somebody. Thinking about giving to a situation that she's closed out. She has a choice to make. But she's really doing her thing. Okay, so let's see what's good. Queen of Swords, part two. Okay, so we have King of Pentacles in the mix. Somebody who's stepping up, who knows what's good with this particular energy, right? None of that, none of the games, none of the hoopla, none of this emotional nonsense. Somebody who's going to get straight to the point. She needs a 10th pentacle, so he's going to give her the 10th pentacle. Okay, all right, okay, it's looking good, Queen of Swords. All right. Ooh, oh, damn it, we got a book and a Queen of Swords, so as soon as she's doing good, she's in her own lane, we got an opposing energy. Just wants to come in here and shake things up. Alright, so it looks like the King of Pentacles is a bit of a wounded warrior. He's had a rough path. Alright, now not only did he have a rough path, you see his little bandage, and you see him using his wand to hold him up. Alright, he's defensive. He knows what's going on, a bit paranoid and traumatized. He's been through a lot. Okay, could be a fire sign. Okay, but looks like she's been secretly investing with this energy, truth and clarity. Okay, very good. Oh, oh, oh. Queen of Swords, King of Wands. Okay, so she's put her boundaries up to the King of Wands, and she's been working with the King of Pentacles. Okay, she's moving towards a soulmate, and she's gained perspective on what she wants and where she's going. Okay, cool. So that's what's going on with that. Okay, that looks like a fighting situation. King of Wands, he's a fighter, and she's just holding a sword like, yeah, I dare you, I dare you. What? All right, cool. So not cool, but yeah. All right, so she's happy, she's celebrating, she's moving towards her, she's gonna be celebrating with this King of Pentacles. Okay, so I'm assuming this was the Emperor that was hidden. Alright. Okay. Looks like somebody's offer is definitely being left out in the cold. Okay. And it seems to be the King of Wands' offer. Alright. She's like, nah, bro. This ain't it. I don't want it. I can't have this. Uh-uh. I'm good. You're reckless, fiery, dangerous, all over the place. Okay, cool. That's a good decision to make. Very good decision to make. Especially if you were already investing with somebody else. Okay. Okay, so That's done. That's done. What's going on with these two? Three of Pentacles reversed. I'm sorry, Three of Pentacles. Oof. Reversed. Why did I say reversed? I'm sure that's going to be fitting in here. Let's see what's going on. Okay, so there's a problem getting towards this generational wealth and success. Maybe it's the fact that he's a wounded warrior. Again, his 10th pentacle is the pentacle needed to give her 10 of pentacles, generational wealth, success, that comfortable, perfect lifestyle and all of that. He is very grounded, down to earth, but he has been through the ringer with the wounded warrior here. Knight of Cups, Five of Cups. Let's clarify the Ten of Wands. Alright, so there's been a tower moment when it comes to these two having their new beginning. Okay. They were giving to each other. They were very much balanced, committed to each other. Understanding, they were playing each other's roles adequately, playing the role adequately for their partner. Both giving to the situation, both very grounded, nurturing, loving, caring individuals. Okay, but then there was a shakeup of tower, which caused the blockage for this Ten of Pentacles for their project. Okay, there's a final decision made and a bunch of fighting. Bunch of fighting. Okay. Alright, tower. Okay, tower. Alright, so there was, I'm not gonna say that was divine orchestration, but that's what's coming out of my mouth. Why? That, I'm not understanding why. Let's see why. Why the Judgment and the Ace of Pentacles? Because there was some anxiety about... Okay, truth and clarity about it. So there was some anxiety. Somebody was trying to have a conversation with the Page of Swords, delayed communication. So they made a final decision based upon that. Maybe they had some news or they were excited about something, a lot of energy. Oh, my bad, I flipped that. And they were attempting to talk to the Queen of Pentacles, and instead the energy wound up disappointed. And I believe that's what caused the tower. Truth and clarity with the Ace of Swords. And now they're King of Swords towards the situation. Okay, so... what's going on with the Queen of Swords? Queen of Swords. She's slowly but surely hurt, slowly but surely moving forward, still putting in work, diligent energy. I think something was revealed with the Moon card here. And I think that caused her to step on her throne from being the Queen of Cups to the Empress. Let's talk about that, the Moon. She was like, look, I'm not giving. Ooh. Sorry. Hey. Okay, there we go. She was like, I'm not giving to this situation. She hopped straight into her Queen of Wands energy, pulled out her little line. She kept the line calm and cool, but she was like, look, I could rip your head off, but I'm not going to. The situation was very painful close, but she definitely released the situation. She seen it for what it was and was like, look, I'm good. Okay. So, now what? Sneaking around, being very calculated, having a new beginning. Damn, she got a lot of aces. A lot of aces. Jeez Louise, she got all the aces. She's the blessed one in this situation. Okay, so let's see what's good and what's going on. So for the Empress, she's going to be very strategic about her moves and what she does. It looks like she is going to have a passionate new beginning with somebody who could be a fire sign. Somebody who's passionate, fiery. I'm not going to say all over the place, but all over the place. She's going to have a new beginning. It's going to be very passionate, and it's going to be a very honest, clear situation. I'm just wondering, is this Knight of Wands? Who is this Knight of Wands? Because she could just be fleeing or moving, migrating, you know what I mean? Very passionately, very happily. Let's see who the Knight of Wands is, because it could very well be the same energy that she's fighting with over there in the corner. Okay, let's go cut that bad boy right there. Like a chef. Cut that bad boy right there. No, I'm just kidding. Okay, let's go bomb the deck. We have an Emperor. Boom. Who is the Knight of Wands? Her new beginning. Her brand new beginning. Okay, very good. The one that she's been keeping secret. Okay. Anything else? Knight of Wands. Three of Pentacles. Two of Wands, Nine of Pentacles. So she's gaining perspective and she wants to work with this energy. She's fired up. She likes this energy. She wants a new beginning with this energy. Very good. Okay, so cool. Let's see how the Knight of King of Wands feels about her. King of Wands. Page of Swords. Oh. Boop. The Hanged Man. How does King of Wands feel about her? How does the King of Wands feel about the Empress? That's his Ten of Pentacles. Maybe they haven't had this talk yet, but he definitely is seeing her from another light. I'm not sure if this is the same energy that she's been fighting with. I think it is, I'm not gonna lie. Ten of Cups. King of Wands. So yeah, this is a brand new option for her. The wheel has spun. And it's bringing in a brand new King of Wands for her. And the soulmate recognition is going to be off the charts. It's going to be phenomenal. It's going to be very happy. It's going to be very good for the two of them. Not going to lie. At first, I thought that they were fighting. But it looks like he's approaching her. And even though she has her sword up to him, he's very confident. He's like, I got this. Who do you? And he's just like, bro, let's go. And they're very much happy and they're in their own world. And it's beautiful vibes, beautiful energy. Great to see that. Oh, my bad. Great to see that we've seen the Black Newman with other situations. So that situation is completely done. She's closed out whatever cycles, doors may have been open. So she's not tracking any dirt from this past situation into her current situation. So, you know, this is good stuff. You know, very, very strategic about the information that she dealt out. Very strategic at the fact that she had a King of Wands approaching her. Everything just perfectly transitioned for her. And you feel me? As you see in all the aces, that's what happens when you're highly favored. So, we're going to leave this right there. Congratulations to you two. And since everything's so popping over here, let's see what's going on with the King of Swords. Alright? It's only right. You feel me? Y'all two going to get it situated, good to go. And, let's see what's good. Alright, so love and light to all. Hope you guys enjoyed the reading. And I gotta start writing down the titles. Yeah. Love you.